Well, so,
sure.
You know, my dad was Muslim.
Yeah.
And he tried to get me to come into Islam. But, you know, I was only about 7-ish, going through 13. And I'm telling you, even as young as I was, something didn't feel right about it. I was just like, what is this? We're bowing down, with like we're doing yoga, we're facing Mecca instead of Jerusalem. But all these things I didn't know then, but it just didn't feel right. So I found a Bible in our house. It was just torn up, no covers or anything. It was just ripped up. And I think I started reading one of the Gospels. And I was reading about Jesus Christ's miracles and all the things he did. And I was like, okay, this is the guy I want to follow. That's, I gave my life to Jesus Christ in a Muslim household on my own.
Wow.
Just by reading the Bible.
Reading a ripped up Bible.
Ripped up.
Didn't even have a complete
Bible. Didn't have a complete Bible. And that's how I gave my life to Jesus Christ at the age of like 13.
That's powerful.
Yes,
that's
amen. So my dad tried to get me to study the Quran, read the whole Quran in Arabic and try to understand all this. But I'm telling you, the spirit, I'm telling you, Jesus Christ put a spirit in me from childhood that didn't allow me to receive it. And I was like, I couldn't talk to my dad like that because we're from West Africa, Nigeria. I couldn't say, Dad, you don't know what you're doing. You can't. I couldn't say that. I just kind of obeyed because you had to do that in a Muslim in household. You had to obey your parents. I mean, Christian parents, people have to do that too, but you know how that goes.
Yeah. It's more strict. I know.
When you start playing computer games and you don't feel like obeying your parents anymore, you just want to be on the computer. But so I had to obey my dad and, you know, submit to the teachings of Islam then, but I couldn't receive it. So I'm 100% proof that you cannot force a religion on a child. If the spirit is not right, they'll reject it.
Now, it
happens to Christians too. When you try and force Christianity on younger children, sometimes they grow older and they're like, I don't want to do it. But then they come back when they're ready. So you can't really force religion.
No, you just need to sow the seed.
Yeah.
And then God gives the increase if he sees fit. You know?
Yeah.
But
you
got to do your part or else you're guilty.
Yeah. And you know what else? This is pretty cool too. He took me out from, he put me in a Catholic school in England. My dad put me in a Catholic school in England because the school system in Nigeria was they're uniting, right? Yeah, so he took me out from Nigeria, the school system there, and he put me in a Catholic school in England, and that's why I became Catholic. I learned to sing Catholicism, and they were not supposed to be doing that because they knew we're Muslim, but they just took me to church anyways, and I wore the gown and I sang in the choir. And I liked it. I liked the hymns. I still like hymns till today. But I'm not Catholic
Brother,
anymore.
Brother, I need to get your contact again. I'd like to get with you again.
See, praise God. This is proof, like he said, that if a person reads the word and has the word, that word has power. It's the word themselves. The words themselves have power. That's what Jesus said, my words are spirit and life. Glory to God. What an amazing testimony.
I mean, I was really glad I was in your house. And I